Hi, I'm Rob of Precision Zone. I'm going to be showing you how to do a quick static check on a Magnetek GPD515 series of crane inverters. Now, the first thing that we're going to be doing is powering off the machine and giving it some time for the DC bus to discharge. Now, this specific inverter does have a charge LED that when it goes out, the DC bus should be completely discharged, but we're going to go ahead and verify that with our digital multimeter. When you're performing these tests, make sure that you're using a quality meter, just like this Hioki 4252 series. You're only going to be able to get reliable, accurate results out of a meter that you have spent some money on. And this specific meter is a very accurate meter at a fair price. So look into getting one of these if you are in need of a digital multimeter. And the first thing that we're going to do when we verify that the DC bus has been discharged is put our meter into the DC mode. And now that we're there, we're going to take the negative side of our digital multimeter and place it on the negative side of the DC bus and the positive side of our meter to the positive side of the DC bus and take a reading. And it looks like we're showing about 0.28 volts, which is great. And I wouldn't proceed any farther if there was anything showing more than 1 volt. So now we can go ahead and do a phase to ground test, and we'll go ahead and put our digital multimeter in the resistance function. Now we're gonna go ahead and find a good ground and place the negative side of our meter there, and then we're going to measure with the positive probe across RS and T and U, V and W. So that should be a great ground there, R, S and T, and then U, V, and W. Okay, that's great. None of the phases are to ground, so let's go ahead and move on to our next check. And we're going to be performing a diode check on the input and output transistor modules. Go ahead and place your digital multimeter into the diode check function. So what we're going to go ahead and do is take the negative probe and put it on the positive side of the DC bus, and then take the positive probe and go between R, S, and T and take a reading. Negative probe, positive DC bus, go R, 0.53, S, 0.53, and T, 0.53. Well, that's great. They're all within the range of between 0.2 and 1 volt, but most importantly, they're balanced across all three phases. So next, we're going to go ahead and switch our leads and take the positive probe and put it on the negative side of the DC bus and use the negative probe and check between R, S, and T. 0.53, 0.53. Great, exactly. Correct range, balanced across all three. Awesome, so the input transistor module is checking good. So now we're gonna use the exact same method to check the output transistor module. So, negative probe, positive DC bus, U, 0.4, V, 0.4, W, 0.4. Great, let's switch our leads. Take the positive probe and put it on the negative side of the DC bus. Go between U and V and W. Well, that's great. The output transistor module checks good as well. And if you're having this exact same thing happen and you're still having a problem with your drive, please reach us at Precision Zone so we can help you further troubleshoot your inverter a little bit more. And as always, we perform free evaluations and provide 12-month warranties on this series of Magnetek crane inverter. Thanks for watching.